Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Romance of the Three Kingdoms 12. I'm the Mysterious JG, and we are playing through the, I think it's called Rival Warlord scenario. It's essentially set immediately after the fall of Dong Zhuo, and we're playing as Cao Cao. Now I can't remember if I was ready to end a turn or had just ended a turn when I ended the last video, so we don't really have anything to... Oh, yeah, I do have to show you something new. I have to show you this mechanic here. You got this. Each city has one, kind of a sort of a central building, palace. I'm sure there's a better actual Chinese word for it. Structure that normally doesn't really have a lot that you can do. Normally, you would have these little three dots going, and somebody says something when you click it. But periodically, an exclamation mark will appear. Haven't really been trying to track this, you know, haven't, like, broken out a pencil and paper and taken notes to see how many turns it takes to get this, and if it's consistent or if it varies, and if maybe this has something to do with, you know, there's some way that you can actually increase how often this happens. But periodically, you will get an exclamation mark here. It means that when you click it, well, first of all, Guo Jia will give us a little tutorial. It's petitions and feats. Oh, I don't think I ever noticed that. Either this is a newly translated or I never noticed before. But yeah, this is petitions from the people. You get to execute, you get to sort of do two petitions. And this tells you what the cost is. Most of them are free. This one here is probably telling you whether it's failable. I don't know. But sometimes you can get a skill, you get fame, and you can pick an officer, whoever executes the feat or helps answer the petition, gets a bonus to one of their statistics. So this means that over the course of the game, if you consistently make the same person, and usually you have, at the beginning you always have a choice of four, and it's always boosting one of the four main skills. Sometimes you get more, and you get a chance to learn skills, i.e., these skills, like reputation, heal, recruit, calm, weaponry, etc. But the worst that can happen is it doesn't work, and the best that can happen is it succeeds. So what I tend to do is I'll just click pull here. This boy gives us a request. You organize your officers for your entire force by pull, and you see who is close to moving up a significant, you know, what's the word I'm looking for here? I mean, if you've got 79 pull instead of 80, having 80 pull is going to increase the number of researches that you could potentially help with researching. So it would be not terribly useful to say, give Cao Cao one more pull, because he's already going to be able to research anything. Giving it to a guy with 79 might push him into being able to research stuff he couldn't research before. Giving it to somebody with 69 might push them up significantly, etc. This guy here's other stats are low enough that he's probably not going to be that useful in research anyway. What about intelligence? This man wants us to do something that will increase our intelligence. Well, here we have Li Dian, who's right on the cusp of being good in... like, great in so many areas. We could give him leader plus one and intelligence plus one, and it would only take two rounds of this to get his war increased. He's somebody I could potentially see spending a lot of time having him do petitions. Eventually, he'll have 80s across the board. He should be one half of the tag team needed to research almost any of the political ones. So let's go ahead and increase Li Dian's intelligence by one. Looking for a criminal. Li Dian? I'm looking for a criminal. Li Dian found a criminal. His intelligence is now 80. Cao Cao's fame has increased by 2. So we get 2 of these per time that that thing lights up for us. We noticed this will cost us 1,000 food, but we noticed... Repel pig? We noticed that his leadership, that same character's leadership, is also at 79. So let's just... go ahead and work on making Li Dian our ultimate research guy. The irony being, of course, that I don't believe he's actually currently in the city with the academies. Is he? Oh, he is. He's actually working on research right now, so never mind. But yeah, as you can see, we're back to having no petitions. Xu Cheng, something something, says Hei Yi. But the next time we have petitions, we can start feeding his pull and leadership, or sorry, war. And eventually, getting his war up is not going to help us in too many different ways. Whoa. I don't want to cancel that research. But it will mean that he could help with whatever officer type he is. He is a archery general, so that would probably mean he could help us with researching archery stuff. In the meantime, I'm still kind of laying out, not getting involved in a lot of combat until some plot events have triggered for us. But we did have three guys in this city who were working on research who are now free to do other things. Putting things on top of other things. So let's automate here. We've got people working each barracks, so our draft is now at 904. Our draft is 1551 here, which is pretty good. And only 1350 here. But we also we put some research into decreasing the cost. Now it's 950 instead of 1,000. So how much are we going to have to improve our facilities before this really pays off? It might not really end up being that big of a thing. But still, let's get everything up to at least level 2. Don't care about the guard stations that much. Because it's increasing our guard, I can't tell if it really increases our fame. And the finder, I don't really know what it does when you increase the finder. But it costs more than it would to increase a level 1 market, so I'm kind of figuring you're probably getting something like value for your money. It's hard to say. I definitely want to get my barracks doing their best. I have everything up to at least level... the markets and barracks and farms I want to get up to at least level 2. So we start running through our money pretty fast this way. And, you know, as long as we're not conquering new territory, maybe I just need to spend the gold, but... agonizing over these decisions, folks. Let's go ahead and increase the finder of lost love as well. It gets pretty expensive when you start boosting stuff up to even higher levels. Not that expensive to boost the plot. Oh, what the hell. We're going to get everything up to level 2. Everything is going to go up to at least level 2. And we'll probably be a little cash strapped for a bit, but this is the core of our empire, folks. It should be in a good shape. Well, it'll be the core of our empire once we have an empire. Oh, I missed the barracks here. I'm surprised. And it's Cao Cao's personal barracks as well. Ooh. It's expensive to upgrade these. I'm not sure what it does. It might speed up how long it takes you to research new technologies, which would be actually pretty dang good. I'm pretty sure it doesn't impact what technologies you were allowed to research. So we just blew through all of our cash, but I take it as a good sign that we had almost exactly enough cash to do this. Well, no one's working this market. Let's put our farmer on that. And that'll help us make up for the fact that I blew through all of our money like a fiend. Now, we've got 3 strategies in the can, but I'm thinking we'll wait a turn or two to use the raid strategy that we developed, because it's currently not going to work on Yuan Shao. Matter of fact, what we might just do is end each turn and then test and see if it will work on Yuan Shao. Employ GFP. Yuan Shu has researched Rays. Something negotiate Shu Jin. What? I don't. Oh. Plot events. Hey! There's Chanan, Liu Ju, and Liu Yan stuff happening, sir. What? Yeah, I told you everything I know. Hey, guys, I think I'm gonna attack Chang'an. What do you think? Or maybe we'll move towards Chang'an, or I'm not sure what's happening. What do you guys think? I don't know what to think, sir, but I've just got really, really good depth perception. I'm the shield of Wei. They just keep coming, prattling on about virtue. Liu Yan! And some Chinese text. Aha, I'm an old man. Take a look at my life, I'm a lot like you. I need someone to love me the whole night through. Okay. So, do we Emperor Jian or not Emperor Jian? That is the question, folks. I'm gonna Emperor Jian. Okay, I've chosen Emperor Jian, guys. Let's go to Liu Yan. Yes! I think the event here is that we're trying to rescue the Emperor from Liu Zhu or Luo Si or whichever one of Dong Zhuo's generals ended up with the Emperor. So this is an actual thing what happened, and it was a big part of Cao Cao's rise to supremacy, as he got power over the Emperor during the chaos early on and was therefore able to act with imperial authority when he essentially became the power behind the throne. Alright, Cao Cao, will Emperor Jian. I will rescue Emperor Jian. And he'll stand up to me if he's got the balls. Dynasty Warriors 7, I haven't played 8 yet. Dynasty Warriors 7 does by far my favorite depiction in Koei games of how the Cao Cao and the Emperor relationship went.
I am Emperor Jian. Look at my awesome beaded curtain hat. Oh, check it out, Cao Cao's army. I'm saved. Cao Cao will be a much better host than Guo Xi or Luo Ji or whoever have been.
Yeah, that's right. Your life is going to be wonderful now that you're under my tender, loving mercies, Emperor Jian.
Oh boy, I can't see this going wrong at all.
Hi, I'm Dong Cheng. JG doesn't really remember who I was, but I have a nice hat.
Are you making plots against me and putting them in clothes or something? I think that happens later.
Xihao Dun, Liu Ji, something.
Right, I got it. I see exactly what you're saying and exactly how far away from me you are. And if you were to throw an object towards me, I'd be able to understand its speed and approach and changing distance with ease because of my incredible depth perception. So we're fighting Li Jue's troops, and we kick their ass. And that's right, I've taken over Liu Yan, I think. We'll find out in a minute. Xuchang is still my favorite city, though. Let's move the Emperor to Xuchang, where he'll be safe. Safe from the freedom to make decisions that will harm the people.
Alright, Cao Cao, this is going to be great. I can't imagine this will be a horrible thing at all.
Well, I think eventually you marry one of my daughters or something. I don't know. Or maybe your daughter marries, or your son marries one of my granddaughter or something. At any rate, it's all going to be good.
And so, Xuchang. In the city of Xuchang, Cao Cao brought in Emperor Jian and everything was wonderful and good forever. Cao Cao, Emperor Jian, Xuchang, Cao Cao, Kong Kong, blah, blah, blah. A lot of stuff happened. Cao Cao is now the chief. The chief M. He's become M Bison. Oh, so we took over a city for free. That's pretty cool. Can't beat that, folks. I just spent all of our money and now we have a new city to build in. That's great. I should not have done that at all. I really shouldn't have done that. If I had known this event was coming on this turn, I definitely would not have spent all of my money.
But we just developed a new technology, so I'm going to feel like I should go get right to work on developing a new technology. But in fact, Puyan something. Shucheng and Wan something. Other things I don't understand. Barracks apparently had a particularly good month. So now he's probably telling us there is nobody in charge of Puyang. No, we have two officers of Puyang. But obviously we need a lot more than that. So I've got 12 officers here, 9 here, and 9 here. So I've got 2 here. If I were to pull 3 from here, we'd have 5. And 6 and 7 if I pulled 1 from each of these. And then I'd have 8, 8, 10. I guess I need to pull even more from there. The thing is, I need more officers here because this place is going to fairly consistently have people doing research. But probably my smart move would be to pull 3 officers out of here. They have a really nice draft going. It's kind of drafty. So yeah, I spent all of our money rather foolishly, not realizing that was coming on the next turn. But this city, what is this city? Wangzhou? Or is that the name of the officer who's in charge around here? Yeah, it's like Puyang or something, I don't know. I probably should know, of course I don't. But this is, looks like it's a pretty big city, actually. Next door is Chang'an, which is an even bigger and more impressive city in some ways. Although it's got land 12, and this place has land 12, so they really have the same economic potential. But we need to get some facilities going here, so let's get going with the basics first. We want to make sure we have... Okay, went down here. I will put the Finder of Lost Loves. Up here, I will put the required barracks, guard post, and plot. How much money have we got left? We've got over 4,000. So the rest of this will be the first city where I will actually put in, even though we're not going to be using them yet, I'm going to put a smith here for building siege wappets. The rest of this needs to be split between farms and barracks. I'm thinking this would be a good... I'm going with one farm. Because Cao Cao, I actually have a technology I can research where I'll get more food out of each farm. So he's really the last leader who would need to have more than one farm going per city. And one of the things I like to do once later in the game, once I've conquered, say, a corner of China and these cities are no longer under any threat, or even as I conquer them, because I'll know that I will soon be turning my attention elsewhere, I can tear down barracks and stuff in these cities and just make, or you know, guard towers or, you know, plot or whatever, and just leave like a finder for purposes of still being able to search for treasure or whatever, but have everything else be markets and farms. So I'm not going to put tons... At this point, I need to keep at least one farm in each city, probably. But I'm not going to put a ton of farms in any of my major cities. I will trust that I will have the opportunity to build up farming at a later time. So we actually came out of that okay. I'm not going to be able to upgrade here immediately, but by the same token, I should still be able to get some good research going here. I can't take anything of these up to level 2 because I spent too much gold. So I could either wait around another turn till I have 4,000 and try to keep going on one of these. But I think, having just talked about how I've only got one farm per city, the next thing I'd like to hit is Cao Cao's speciality, which is to increase food output. And this is something I am not going to like rush to max out. But again, the earlier you hit these things, the more beneficial they are. And we're not really rushing into combat right now. We might as well keep doing the political, economical ones for the time being. Fame would be a good one to get eventually, too. Convoy. I mean, none of these are useless, except possibly bargain, because I don't understand how diplomacy works. Anyway. Then again, maybe the reason diplomacy, I mentioned in a previous video, it seems like they want so much for every, you know, just to give you anything, and they want this huge amount in return. Maybe it's because I haven't researched bargain. I honestly don't know. See, Li Dian, he's the dude. So... we're now going to be in a position where this guy here, Li Jue, he might be looking for a little revenge, and you never know when this guy might make his move. So we don't want to have a bunch of crap officers here, but I really don't want to pull my best officers out of Zhu Chang either. Especially because Zhu Chang is in a position to support two different cities that could be attacked. Zhu Chang itself only has one hostile bordering it. So I think I'll keep Cao Cao himself here. Oh, the other thing is it's... okay, still not affecting Yuan Shao, so I'm going to wait one more turn. And if it's still not affecting Yuan Shao, I'm going to assume that's because we're allied. And therefore, I'm not plundering his lands. I don't know if it's because he did use a tactic which prevents people from using tactics against him. So I really don't know if that's what's going on. So there's Puyan. Just to make doubly sure, I'll select it by a map. Oh, it's Luyan that we want to send people to. Because Puyan's over here. Ah, alright. And, Jihao N had been hard at work on research, so he might be a good guy to keep around. Send some of our yellow turbans over there. They're not the hottest officers ever, but... well, you know, maybe we'll send them and Jihao N, because he's a decent officer. Again, if they get in trouble, we're going to end up sending... you know what? No, we'll send you on Jihao Yuan over there. That way I'll have at least one guy... who I know has really good leader in war and can whoop the shit out of anybody who gives us trouble. Our lord can't move to other city. Even if Cao Cao is selected, we get this message saying, our lord can't move to other city. And for a while, I was confused that there was something, like, wrong with my game. So we're going to get you to work here. You're already working in a barracks.
Yarzo!
Get Cao Cao working. You know what? Let's automate and see what they do. They keep putting Cao Cao on the plot thing. They're also trying to get an officer working the farm instead of doing the leadership thing. Maybe he has like really awesome farm stats, this guy. No, not really. They just don't think that I should have one farm with no one working it. And three barracks, all of which are being worked. But I really do like to have a nice high troop count. So now I need to send some officer out of here over there. To Luyan. I want to send somebody who can fight. So I'm going to send Cao Hong. He was working a market, so maybe we'll get Sima Wang off of the farm. Although, as you can see from his picture, he does appear to be growing tobacco or marijuana or something, so... we come over here, I'll need to take one officer... and, I don't want to, like, take all of my officers. You know, if I was going to move a military dude, I should have moved them out of here, because this city has kind of a lot of them. Yuejin, Dian Wei, Zhuzhu. He's over here looking for treasure. He's got your rum. He's looking for treasure. He's a pirate, folks. You're dead. Anyway, none of these guys appear to be able to do anything awesome with the search. But I'm going to leave that alone for right now, because we think we're out of hidden treasure over here. Same token, I've got a guy over here searching for stuff by, you know, night and day. He's just searching for whatever. And over here, you are trying to hire Leon. And you're just going to keep at it forever. So let's let you work on that. Meantime, I've got 3 people have left here. That's why they're not working. 1 person's left here. And 1 person's left here. So that's 3, 4, 5 that are heading here. And there are already 2 here. So this place is actually going to end up with 7 officers. While these 2 are going to have 8. And Cao Cao is going to have 9. So I guess I need to send 1 more out of Cao Cao City here. If I'm just determined to have an even distribution. No, I don't really want to move any of you guys. And I, you know, do I want to split up Cao Cao and his lovely wife? Dong Chang was a big part of our success over there, so I could move him. And my gold is gonna drop, but I do wanna keep the troops coming in. So it's 1405, 907, 1267. Then again, you know, poor Lubu's got less than 500. But we're not pulling ahead in troop counts of Yuan Shao, and he's after Liu Bu is going to be our big challenge. Then again, over here we are recruiting in troops better than some of our other regional rivals. Cao Cao just has a much better officer corps than any of these guys do. This guy here has 8 officers, but I mean, it's guys like this guy. Check out this guy. What's he gonna do, huh? I mean, look at this. This is, this guy here is seriously one of your officers here. Check this guy out. I don't remember who he is, but that picture suggests to me that he's not, like, the best officer in all China. Meanwhile, I've got 2 people over here, but there's no facilities for them to work yet, so they're just gonna hang out. And, I think that's gonna be a good place for us to end the turn. Let's end the turn and then end the video. So it's Liu Zhang is research fame. He's famous for being a laughingstock of future peoples. Somebody used the cut road strategy. Oh no, there's more events. I really wanted to end the video. Liu Bei, Liu Bu, Xiaopei. Yeah, let's do the tiger eats 2 dragons strategy, or dragon and tiger fight for food, or something. What are you talking about? We should make Liu Bei fight Yuan Shu, and now you got the emperor, you can tell Liu Bei to do stuff, and he has to do it. And if he succeeds and defeats Yuan Shu, that's pretty cool for us. But if he fails and dies, that's cool for us too. Liu Bu is involved in this somehow. Wow, you're a cold-ass motherfucker, Junyu. Cao Cao wants us to do something, like, with Yuan Shu, or he's got Yuan Shu coming to kill us, or... JG doesn't remember, but Cao Cao has definitely got some plots going where he's got you, Liu Bu, and Yuan Shu all fighting each other while Cao Cao reaps the rewards. By the way, I'm Dicked Mac. What? Cao Cao's an asshole. Liu Bei, here are orders from Cao Cao, but they're coming from the Emperor, but they're totally from Cao Cao. I'm like Mr. Restore the Han. I have to listen to the Emperor. Fuck. Well, I guess I'll do what the Emperor says.
But the Emperor's not telling you it's Cao Cao. How fucking stupid are you?
Shut up, Zhang Fei.
I'll stay behind and guard the city, I guess.
Yeah, okay. Cao Bao and other things are also happening. Let's do this shit.
Yeah, bitches!
So Liu Bei's army went off and did something, but I don't remember what.
Okay, this is awesome. I'm gonna guard the city, because, you know, Liu Bu is, like, right on our border, and even though he told us he's our friend, everyone knows he's a fucking asshole. So I'm gonna guard the city while Liu Bei is off doing stuff with Yuan Shu. He warned me not to get drunk, so I promised I wouldn't get drunk. And in celebration of this fact, let's all get really drunk. But, you know, after tonight, we'll stop getting drunk all the time. Cao Bao, get drunk with me!
I don't really want to do that.
I'm gonna beat the shit out of you!
Zhang Fei, I really don't want to get drunk.
I'm gonna beat the shit out of you! I didn't say it had anything to do with whether or not you were gonna drink.
Liu Bu's like my uncle's cousin. Like, I, you know, Liu Bu, like, he's this, he knows this guy. And, like, you know, we totally used to hang together and stuff, so you don't want to mess with me.
What? Liu Bu, you think I'm scared of that pussy? I'm gonna fucking murder you! Cao Bao, I order you to get like 1,000,000 lashes.
Oh shit! And so Cao Bao eats like 1,000,000 lashes because Zhang Fei wanted him to get drunk and he said no, and then he really fucked up by telling Zhang Fei to back off because he knows Liu Bu. And the lashes continued. Zhang Fei had Cao Bao beaten like, you know, a scalded dog. Or, no, that's how you run. That's not how you're beaten. You're beaten like a government mule. And, Cao Bao, understandably not that pleased about this, sends a letter to Liu Bu. Meanwhile, armies. Liu Bu gets the word. He's like, Zhang Fei!
Zhang Fei, I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Well, actually, he gets the letter and he's basically like, shows it to his advisor and like, what do I make of this? And his advisor's like, this is a really good pretext for you to take Liu Bei's city. And Liu Bu's like, oh, cool.
You're not gonna take the city, Liu Bu. I'm gonna personally beat the shit out of you. But I'm like, really hungover.
Zhang Fei, look, I'm really sorry this went down the way it did.
Die!
And he kills Cao Bao. Yeah, Zhang Fei kills Cao Bao because of that. In the meantime, Zhang Fei has to retreat because, you know, he doesn't really have, like, an army. And he's also too fucking hungover to fight, so he retreats. And Zhang Fei's like,
guys, I'm sorry. I kind of lost our only city.
What? You lost our city? We, like, swore brotherhood. We're gonna, like, restore the Han? What the fuck is wrong with you?
I'll kill myself to make it up to you. We're not there yet. JG's skipping ahead in the dialogue. Okay. Okay, now is the time for me to threaten to kill myself? Yes! You know what? Don't threaten to kill yourself. Kill yourself, you dumb fuck. Okay. This is all Liu Bu's fault, but it's also my fault, so I'm gonna kill myself. What? No! Stop!
Women and children are just like garments that can be mended, but brothers are like arms, and once you rip them off, they don't really work that well if you just sew them back on. So, because women and children are worthless, I ask you not to kill yourself, you drunken asshole who lost me my only city. And more Chinese proverbs.
You're such a good friend! I love you, man!
Me too. Oh god, what did I get myself into? I'm thinking the same thing, buddy. Anyway, let's go to Cao Cao. Cao Cao seems like a good guy. He'll totally take care of us, look after us. We're not going to have any troubles if we put our faith in Cao Cao.
That's awesome! Liu Bei's fucked now!
Oh, I'm such an asshole.
Good job, Zunyu. Oh, by the way, when you said you had that strategy, I forgot to say exactly my thoughts. It's no problem. It was implied, sir.
I look like I'm planning something.
But, you know, we still need to take care of Liu Bu, and I've got a plan for that. It's called Crouching Tigers, Dragon Fingers. Cool. We'll do that. But first, we've also got to figure out how to deal with Liu Bei, because in this game, he still manages to have a city. Cao Cao, look, we got thrown out of our city, and we've heard that you're just a really good guy. Is there any way? Liu Bei, why don't you just take over Runan, and you can hold it as a bulwark against Liu Bu, and I'll find a way to use you for my own advantage later. You're such a good friend. Tiger and Wolf, Liu Bu, Liu Bei, Zhang Fei, Cao Bao, Liu Bei, Cao Cao, Runan, other things. Cao Bao is dead. And a bunch of people moved which cities they take over. So as you can see, this unoccupied city here goes to Liu Bei. I believe, had I settled it, I still would have given it to Liu Bei for plot reasons. Either that, or had I taken it over, I would have broken it, and that story event would have happened. Meanwhile, Ma Tang has increased his fame research stuff. And we're ready to start a new turn. Liu Yan, 6 officers have arrived there. This guy's got some stuff to tell us. And other things as well. Liu Bei, Zhang Ba. And now I can do what I meant to do 10 minutes ago, which is end this video. Alright, folks, so a whole bunch of story went down. We increased our holdings and stuff. We got better facilities at our 3 earlier cities, although everything here is still at level 1. But when we come back, we'll distribute officers across our newly held city, and just based on the map, we now look like one of the powers of Central China. I'm the Mysterious JG. I'd like to thank you guys very much for watching, and I hope you'll join me next time for another adventure in Romance of the Three Kingdoms 12. Goodbye.